All praise and glory belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and may His finest peace and blessings be upon the best of His creation, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and his family and his companions and all those that follow his footsteps until the day of judgment. May Allah make us of them. Allahumma ameen. To veil or not to veil? That is the question. This evening, insha'Allah ta'ala, is for every one of our sisters who loves Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This evening is for every sister that lives in defense of the Qur'an and the Sunnah and lives for Jannah. This evening is for every sister that has forgotten who she is. I want to speak to you, but the real you. I don't want to speak to the lipstick or the color contacts or the pink hair or the loud gum or the head bouncing to the iPod or the cowgirl boots or the fake nails. I want to speak to you, the real you, your heart and your soul and your mind, about those things buried deep down inside of you that I wish that you could remember. Don't you remember who you are? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says,
إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ أُولَٰئِكَ هُمْ خَيْرُ الْبَرِيَّةِ.
Those that have iman, the believing men and the believing women, the mu'min and the mu'mina, and do good deeds, these are the best of the creation. You, who you are, you are the best of the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are a member of the only remaining nation on the face of the earth, from its east to its west, that believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and worships Him alone without any partners. You are the only ummah on the face of the earth. You are its member that has not disbelieved in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is who you are. You are the slave of Allah. What an honor. Like one, he said, وَمِمَّا زَادَنِي شَرَفًا وَتِيهَا وَكِدْتُ بِأَخْمُصِي أَطَأُ الثُّرَيَّ دُخُولِي تَحْتَ قَوْلِكَ يَا عِبَادِي وَأَنْ صَيَّرْتَ أَحْمَدَ لِي نَبِيًّا. And from what has increased me in honor and prestige until I was about to touch the stars with my fingertips is my being included in your words, O my slaves, and that you sent Muhammad to me as my prophet. What an honor. That is who you are. The brother, he is Abdullah, he is the slave of Allah. The sister, she is Amatullah, the slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then when it comes to the topic of veiling, it tears me apart when I hear a sister say, or I hear that she said, or her brother comes running to me saying, my sister is telling me, convince me about hijab. La ilaha illallah. That statement, convince me about hijab, you might as well just say, convince me about Islam. Because the one that has already been convinced and made the decision to be a believer, the believing man and the believing woman, listen to their description in the Quran. Allah says,
وما كان لمؤمن ولا مؤمنة إذا قضى الله ورسوله أمرا أن يكون لهم الخيرة من أمرهم ومن يعص الله ورسوله فقد ضل ضلالا مبينا.
And it is not befitting, it's just not right, that a believing man or a believing woman, when Allah and His Messenger have decreed a matter, for them to have any say in it. And whomever disobeys Allah and His Messenger, then they have deviated. They have been led astray, and it is so obvious that they have been misguided. You are a believer, aren't you? Ask yourself that question. I am a believer. Yes, I am a believer. Do you know then what a believer is supposed to say? Not supposed to say, convince me. Allah says,
إنما كان قول المؤمنين إذا دعوا إلى الله ورسوله ليحكم بينهم أن يقولوا سمعنا وأطعنا وأولئك هم المفلحون.
The saying of the believers when they are being invited to Allah and His Messenger, Al-Imam Al-Qurtubi says, Quran and Sunnah, they say nothing else except, we hear and we obey. And these are those that are successful. Who doesn't want to be successful? Don't you want to be successful in the dunya and the akhirah? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَمَن يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ فَقَدْ فَازَ فَوْزًا عَظِيمًا.
And whosoever obeys Allah and His Messenger, then they have succeeded to the ultimate success, to the greatest success. So this hijab, it is just another command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that mandates our obedience to it. Refusing it then is a sin. But we hear that word sin too much. What does it mean it's a sin? Meaning it's a crime. It's a felony. Why? Because Allah commanded the believing woman to wear hijab. So when she refuses, she has stepped on the command of the king. And Allah is not the one that no is to be said to. Sister, aren't you scared for yourself? Wallahi, I'm scared for you that you think it's just another sin. It's just a sin. Question. What removed Adam alayhi salam from Jannah? It was just a sin. Adam alayhi salatu wasalam was forgiven. What caused Shaytan alayhi la'natullah to spend eternity in the hellfire? It was one sin. And just to clarify matters, so no one gets confused, we want to make it very clear. Hijab is not just another sin. There's a hadith in Sahih Muslim, narrated by Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He says that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, صنفان من أهل النار لم أرهما. Two types of the people of the fire that I have never seen. The scholar said what this means is that of the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he did not have to see these two types of people. The first type, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam describes a particular kind of tyrant, a relentless tyrant. The second type, he says sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ونساء كاسيات عاريات مائلات مملات. And women that are kasiyat, they have clothes on, they have fabric on their bodies. عاريات, but they're naked. They're wearing clothes, but it's as if they're not wearing anything.